The next verse, he's describing his own progression. He's saying, Bhava. He's saying, Bhava. I was doing meditation. I was wandering. I was doing my sadhana. I was doing my meditation. I was following the shruti that I had heard from the gurus, chanting my mantra, meditating. I came to the state of Bhava, became transformed, feeling separation, crying, and eagerness. Then I went immediately, because Bhava immediately follows prema very fast. I came to prema. And it was not an ordinary prema. It was atibhara. Heavily laden, heavy prema, atibhara. Pulaka, feeling anga pulaka. This is the hair standing in and all over my body. And ati nivritta, overwhelmed, ananda. Samplave. Samplave means ocean. Lina means absorbed. Actually, samplave means to be submerged. Samplave. I was submerged in this bliss. Ananda samplave means I was submerged in bliss, basically. I was drowning in bliss in every part of my body. And napashyam ubayam mune. I couldn't see anything. Love is blind. Love made me blind. And I saw the Lord. I lost all contact. Oh, Vyasadeva, at that time, I became so overpowered by feelings of happiness, ananda, bliss, loving bliss, premananda. Every part of my body became separately enlivened, being absorbed in the ocean of ecstasy, ananda samplave. I couldn't see myself or the Lord. So spiritual feelings of happiness and intense ecstasies have no mundane comparison. Therefore, it's very difficult to give expression to such feelings. We can just have a glimpse of such ecstasy in the words of Sri Narada Muni. Each and every part of the body or senses has its particular function. After seeing the Lord, all the senses become fully awakened to render service unto the Lord. Because in the liberated state, the senses are fully efficient in serving the Lord. As such, in that transcendental ecstasy, it so happened, the senses became separately enlivened to serve the Lord. This being so, Narada Muni lost himself in seeing both himself and the Lord simultaneously. It's a really beautiful exchange. So it's really very intimate. He's saying, listen, I became sadhana siddhi. Of course, ultimately it's kripa siddhi because it was Mahabhagavas blessed him. And it's mercy from his previous life, his guru in his previous life, and his previous sadhana. So ultimately everything's kripa siddhi, but the progression appears to be sadhana siddhi. I did my sadhana, I rose through the states of bhava, then I came to prema, so I attained perfection. So this is perfection.